Hey artists, welcome to the 21st painting in my 30 paintings in 30 days challenge. We're almost at the end, we're getting there. I'm getting to paint another Sphinx cat today, which I'm very happy about. So what I wanted to talk about today is kind of how I go about preparing for a painting and edging into a little bit of the painting process. So one of the things I really liked about this challenge is that it really allowed me to sort of develop a defined painting process, and that often starts before I even take out a brush. For this particular challenge, I wanted to keep things very much the same as far as the process went. My color palette is very defined and limited. I chose only 10 animal subjects to repeat throughout, all sorts of stuff like that. But my process always starts before I even take out a brush. My very first step that I go through when I am about to embark on a new painting adventure is to get clear on why I want to create this new piece of art. That to me is very important because it's one of those things that it's going to help you keep pushing forward, but also acting with intention is going to be key for really pushing you forward and to make sure that what you're doing is in alignment with what feels good, and it's going to make your life so much easier. So the first step, get clear on why you want to create that artwork. Maybe it's for a commission, maybe it's for a challenge, maybe it's to learn. Maybe it's for fun. And basically, whatever your why is, you can set your expectations accordingly. If I am creating a new piece of artwork for the purpose of learning, then I'm gonna really push myself and try to actually learn something new. Whereas if the why behind, you know, why I wanna create this artwork is to have fun, well then, I'm gonna go really easy on myself as far as my expectations go. I'm not gonna judge myself for it not looking perfect or anything like that. It's for fun. So get clear first on why you wanna create that art. The next thing I get clear on is kind of the vibe or the mood that I wanna achieve. And this can definitely be aided by things like color, your level of contrast, the lightness or darkness of the painting. So I like to get clear on the vibe or mood. And then once I've kind of got clear on those things, I'm actually going to start looking for references and inspiration. Usually by this point, I've got pretty clear inspiration, but I want to actually start taking action to move towards creating my artwork. So that's where I gather references. And from those references, I usually create my sketch. So now we're actually starting the painting process. I create my sketch, and then usually I will transfer it to my surface. Sometimes I will draw it directly onto my surface, but you do you. And then typically what I do, it's definitely prominent in this challenge that I'm doing, is I usually like to create some sort of colored ground for my paintings. So here I'm going with sort of that loose watercolor effect, and all I really did here was dilute some acrylic paint, just using a basic brown, and then letting the paint kind of do its thing and flow. The reason why I do this is because I want to give myself something that's not boring white to work on. And then once that's dry, basically I start painting. I start most of my paintings with this sort of process, and honestly, I find that it really helps me to set myself up for success. So maybe that kind of got your brain turning a little bit about how you can start to prepare for your next painting. All right, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.